By training, I am a clinical neuropsychologist, so I do see patients in private practice. We can see when we're actually doing clinical practice that there's a lot of areas in neuropsychology that are lagging behind in technology. We look at the cognitive effects of stroke, specifically we look at neuropsychological function after a stroke, things like memory, executive function, planning, and then we kind of examine how do we assess those and whether they can predict functional outcome after the stroke.
My research at UBCO and at the Plan Lab focuses on a phenomenon called neglect in stroke patients, which basically means that an individual who's had a right hemisphere stroke is essentially ignoring half of their visual world, so they're missing out on quite a lot in their visual world. What we wanted to know was if we could differentiate between different subtypes of neglect and whether those subtypes would impact functional outcomes. So we use a really novel eye tracking system to assess whether people have neglect, what kind of neglect they have, and then whether that impacts their ultimate functional outcome and their prognosis overall.
In sum, sort of what we're working on here in the lab is really trying to understand brain and behavior and how that relates to certain clinical populations and certain clinical phenomena to help advance the research in neuroscience.
We've been really lucky in our lab to have access to a lot of really great technology, some really high-end, state-of-the-art stuff like our eye-tracking system that we use. And what's so great about that is that it's really novel, it's really new, nobody's using it. We're able to get a really great wealth of data. It spits out tons of numbers. For us to be able to have access to that and to apply it to our research is absolutely fantastic. It's incomparable to other labs. My name is Jen Upshaw, and I am a master's level student in the clinical psychology program at UBCO.
My name is Damien Leitner, and I'm a graduate student at UBCO in the clinical psychology program, and I'm a PhD student.
Having the potential to actually move this stuff forward, it's really a wonderful opportunity for a graduate student, especially one that is involved and hoping to go into clinical practice as I am.
This is a very new line of research. It's very young, and so right now, what we'd like to do is actually develop some applicable interventions. So based on some of this data we're collecting, really looking at, okay, these are the deficits we're seeing, how can we actually develop an intervention that may help the person recover faster?